Louis Tomlinson.
Now then.
Here he is. New music out, selling out tours on the daily. I mean.
Hey, it's a good time. It's a good time at the moment.
Yeah?
Yeah, I feel like I've been waiting for this moment for a while, you know. I've just announced the tour, just announced the album, so I'm feeling good.
Let's go in on this album then, because I think fans were sleuthing it before you announced it. Standard fans, but Walls, end of January. Is it done? Is it? Have you finished it?
Yeah, fully. Everything's fully mastered, fully signed off. That was as of about 2 weeks ago. And about 3 weeks ago, I had a listen down to the album top to bottom. And I'm not going to lie, I'm proud of it. I'm really happy with where we finished up. So,
what's that moment then when you're working on these tracks individually, you're thinking that, oh, this is going to be the through line here. And then when you do listen to it top to bottom, I mean, that's a different experience in itself.
Yeah, and I feel like you've got to be quite disciplined. You know, I've had this album especially some songs, for a while. So you kind of got to take yourself away from it and stop listening to everything too much, basically. And then, you know, let it rest and then give it a listen top to bottom without. And you've got to try and get yourself in the headspace of a fan, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
And the people who are going to buy the record. But yeah, overall, I was pretty proud, I'm not going to lie.
Are you one of those people that sit there and listen to the masters like on repeat and repeat and repeat like 60, 70, 80 times? Or do you just kind of go like, there it is?
I think I like to trust my gut and so I think in those kind of... I think you can listen to things too much. And I think, you know, if you listen to a song 20 times, you will find something in there that you think, oh, maybe I'll change this. But that's probably just because you've heard it 20 times. Do you know what I mean? So, I like to give things a couple of listens, see how they make me feel, and then don't really think too much about it.
Yeah. So we've had a little bit of a taste. Three tracks are out there. And they're now there. They're in people's lives. They're being digested. They're on people's phones. Mm-hmm. I think people are trying to get them to, you know, that playlist on your phone, top 25 most played.
Yeah.
They're trying to get it to the top. So how's that then? You know, I think it's always an interesting thing asking artists about when you've got that album and it's done and you get to then go, here's a little bit.
Well, I'm not going to lie. You know, as I said before, because I've taken a bit of time with this album, I'm just like, I think normally at this stage of being this close to releasing the album, like I would have thought I would have been a bit more, just a little bit more nervous about it. But I feel like I've been through every emotion now on this process that I'm just really excited to get it out there now. So just, you know, the fact that we've been releasing a couple of songs here, Kill My Mind, We Made It, another single coming in like 4 weeks, 6 weeks, something like that. It just basically... It reinforces my confidence in the album, basically. It's, you know, when I released Kill My Mind, it felt a bit of a statement of intent. It was kind of like I'm moving into a slightly different direction musically. And how that was taken, like, by the fans and stuff. And I think they can recognise that I feel comfortable on that. And the fact that they're, like, okay with it and enjoy it, like, yeah, it makes me feel really good.
I listened to, I'm going to say, like, a millisecond of We Made It. And I was literally taken straight back to being like three or four. And I remember like me being on my dad's shoulders and just that moment of like, it's very noughties. It's very kind of like, you know,
you're nostalgic.
And that's a really nice thing for fans to have because, you know, some of them are quite young and wouldn't have experienced that. And you're bringing that into 2019.
Yeah. And I feel like, I always feel funny saying this because people younger and older always take mickey out of it. But I feel like I'm at an age where, you know, I am more conscious of age than I was when I was 21. I didn't even think about it. You know what I mean? So naturally, I think these things, these nostalgic thoughts and reflection are on my mind more than they were, say, 3 years ago. So I think it does come through in the writing.
So does.
Yeah.
So the thread in the DNA does have this like Oasis twang to it. It has all that. And like I've said before, I say it all the time when I'm playing your tracks. I mean, it just feels like you've arrived in that now and you're just, it feels like you've been doing that for like decades.
Well, I appreciate that. I mean, I think I've said before, I think, you know, in the past I've made records, I've made singles that weren't necessarily for me and didn't necessarily fully represent me. And I feel like, you know, with this promo run and Kill My Mind, We Made It, the next single, they do represent me. And I think people can see that. And the authenticity, I hope, is what makes it like credible, you know?
Yeah, but it's also not a bad thing to go through that process and finding the things like, you know, you've spoken about finding that sound and honing it in, but then also being able to reflect back on those times, because, you know, even 2-3 years ago, that's a different time to now.
Definitely. And I needed to go through that stage in my career. you know, when I did the Steve Aoki song, although, you know, would I feel 100% comfortable doing that kind of production now? Maybe not, but it was right at the time. Mm. And also, I got to do things like play Ultra Festival, which I'd never, which ever done sick. With One Direction, obviously. It was so sick, man. It was really, really fun.
Yeah.
So, and, you know what I mean? Can't complain.
Yeah, you've got them in your back pocket. If you're like, I want to do that festival over there. The massive dance one.
Yeah, exactly.
Speaking of 1D, I feel like you're all still quite telepathic because you've all released music at the same time.
Ah, it's nice for One Direction fans, isn't it? Yeah.
But it's also just nice for everyone else to see how you've all grown and how you've all developed. You know, each one of your sounds is so individual and unique. And I think that's the nice thing to have this kind of buffet.
Yeah, that's a good way of putting it. Yeah.
I guess you when you tap in with the boys and stuff, it's just like, it must just be really nice to be like, this is what we're doing now. We're all in our mode kind of thing.
Yeah, definitely. I've said before, you know, I used to, at the start of my solo career and actually vice versa with the other lads as well, we would send each other our songs more often. I think naturally because we're going into unknown, you know what I mean, as solo artists. Whereas now, as time goes on, like I heard Niall's track for the first time on the radio and kind of experiencing it and digesting it as a fan completely, you know what I mean? And that was an interesting experience. But I think it's a good moment for us all individually. You know, it kind of shows what we all brought to the party, essentially. Yeah.
And you're all smashing it, which is very nice to see.
Yeah. Well, we got a good fan base, yeah.
Oh, you do. So it's live. It's happening.
I didn't realize it was so close.
It's crazy. We're back in this arena scenario as well, and it must be buzzing for you to be able to. It's kind of like a no stakes scenario here. You get to go on, you get to play a couple of songs, and then, you know, enjoy the rest of that atmosphere as well.
Yeah, I mean they're always fun to play those radio shows. Do you know what I mean? It's always and the audience is always good. It's always good, really good for families and stuff like that. Like my sisters are a little bit older now, but they used to go all the time to that kind of thing. You know what I mean? So it's always good for that. And in terms of as an artist, I mean, you know, there's not that much pressure. You turn up, you do four songs. It's not a full set. And you're playing to an arena, so can't complain. It'll be good.
And we'll look after you. I mean, we'll sort the rider.
Well, I've heard the rider is going to be mad by the sounds of it. So yeah.
Mariah Carey could get puppies at any event she can go. You could just be like, I want a boat.
Yeah.
Like 50 miles away from water, don't care, want it.
Yeah, exactly. I'm going to give it a go.
Yeah. I totally think you
starting
should.
Starting with hits one.
You turn up now and I'll just feel like the runner trying to get all this stuff. So, I mean, I can't have you here and not talk about your fans, obviously. You know, I think it's so lovely that is the biggest part of everything you do as well.
Definitely.
And the last time we spoke, they were just sensational. They, you know, my mentions were blown out. So I don't know what your phone's like. Your battery life must, like, not exist.
Luckily, I got my notifications turned off.
And the lovely thing about it is, as well, they look out for you. They look out for each other as well.
Definitely. And that's... it's amazing to be a part of that, the sense of community between them, you know what I mean? And there's fans that I've spoke to, you know, over the years in One Direction, also like going out on my own now, that they didn't know each other before, you know, their thing in common, their mutual thing in common is either liking One Direction or liking me as an individual. Yeah. And then, you know, people are making mates online. There might be people who didn't even speak the same language before, like all these things, that element of community. I think that is definitely the good side of social media. Do you know what I mean? I think they really do utilize that.
Yeah. You should just take that offline, start a country.
Yeah, you're right.
Start
you're
like
right.
A Louis country.
We're getting ideas today, aren't we? Yeah, I'm putting them back.
Right. So I wanted to do something special for one of your fans.
Amazing.
Because they're obviously, you know, they love you so much. And I want to surprise them. So what I've got is a fan called Tony.
Right.
She thinks she's just going to leave you a video message.
Nice.
But then, you know, I mean, you're free to come and answer the question.
Right,
if you want.
Right. Sounds good. Sounds good. Yeah, let's do it.
All right, let's do this. Hello, what's your name?
I feel so ugly from this angle.
Oh, what are you talking about? No, you look beautiful. You're Tony, aren't you?
I'm not used to seeing myself like this.
How's it going?
good. How are you?
I'm doing very well. I'm doing very well. So what we're doing is we're basically just asking a couple of Louis Tomlinson fans to leave a little video message for him.
Uh-huh.
And then you think you can do that? Well, that's good, because that's what I'm asking you to do. Cool. So all I want you to do is just say, hi, my name is Tony, and my question for Louis is, and whatever it is, if that's okay.
Okay. What now?
If you want to do it now, yeah, that'd be great. Let's go for it.
Hello, my name's Tony, and my question for Louis is, what are the vibes for the new album?
What are the vibes for the new album? What a question.
That's a good question.
It's a very good question. Someone might want to answer that for you.
Oi, oi! Now then, love, now then.
Hello.
You all right?
Good, how are you?
Yeah, I'm all right, thanks. I'm all right. I can see you on four screens here. How's it going? Yeah, you had a good day?
I have. I've just been driving around trying to find a parking space all day.
Decent, decent. Okay, answer to your question, what are the vibes for the album?
Oh my God, how weird.
vibes for album, love. Lyrically, I always try and be as honest as possible, so there'll be some honesty in my lyrics. And musically, I always like to keep it, you know, organic and live, so there'll be some guitars in there and that. But anyway, more importantly, what are you having for lunch?
What a question.
Well, I'm vegan at the moment. I'm doing vegan for November. So okay. I don't know what I'm having.
Is that a thing, okay. Vegan for November? Don't they normally have to like rhyme and come together?
Well, not right. So I do Veganuary, but me and my family do vegan November as like a pre. I don't know.
I like it. I like it. Have you tried the vegan sausage roll from Greg's?
I haven't.
What are you doing with your life?
Have you, Louis?
I haven't, because I'm not going to lie. You know, each to their own. I just don't understand going into Greg's and getting a vegan sausage roll in the same way I wouldn't go to McDonald's and get a salad. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I just don't really go into Greg's either, to be honest. So why would I go there suddenly for a vegan
exactly. So true.
Oh, that is like an advert for Greg's, but not. Tony, have you got anything else you want to say to Louis while you've got him here?
I just want to say you look really dashing and beautiful.
God bless you, love.
I really like your T-shirt.
It's a jumper, but I'll let you off.
Tony, thank you so much. Thank you.
Thanks, love darling. You. Thanks. Loads of love. Bless you. Ta-ra. See ya.